This is the instruction and repair video for the 5300B API coupler made by Dixon Baco. The first thing you want to do is turn your coupler over. You're going to push in the interlocking cam. Make sure your fingers are clear and out of the way. Engage the fingers. Now your coupler is actuated. Turn the coupler back over. Now you're going to go in with your needle nose pliers and you're going to remove the stainless steel cotter pin. Once you removed your stainless steel cotter pin, you open up your coupler. You're going to pull your handle out, your shaft assembly. And the way that you remove these is the order that you wanted to set it down in. Spacer, your bushing. And so you take your handle off, set it down, take your handle packing out, down. Wave springs, and your FKM-B seal cylinder. It's a bonded nose seal, which means it's permanently in place here. Now you're ready to inspect your coupler. Once you've inspected your coupler, you're going to replace it with a brand new FKM-B bonded nose seal. Make sure your wave springs are good. Put them in place. Put your FKM-B seal cylinder in place. Now we'll turn the coupler over and we're going to set it right down on your yoke. Once we've done that, now you're ready to put your handle back in place. Before you do, you want to put your handle packing in. That's back in. Now as you insert your handle, you want to make sure you put your bearing back in place. Take your spacer. You're going to put that back in place. Now before we put the pin in, we're going to actuate the coupler to make sure the seals go together well, that there's no binding. Now we've done that, we're going to actuate it back. Now we're ready to put our stainless steel cotter pin back in place. Stainless steel cotter pin is in place. We'll bend it back. Flatten it out. Now your coupler is ready to be put back into service. In addition to the 5300B, we also have the 5400B. The difference being that this is a replaceable nose seal. So this nose seal, rather than being bonded, is actually replaceable. So we can get in here, we can remove the seal, remove the O-ring, and we can also remove this felt dust seal. When replacing the FKM-B nose seal, look for the yellow painted dot. This will be the face-up side of the seal. If you flip the seal over, you'll notice a step in the seal. This step fits into the groove on the nose piece. Simply push in and press down. If the seal is not put in place properly, it can be washed out during service. Double check your gasket, make sure it's seated properly. And now it's in place and ready to be put back in service. When doing your inspection, you should inspect your locking latch to be sure that it's not bent or disformed or disfigured. Check your cams, make sure that they are not disformed, disfigured, or damaged. Be sure to check your seals for swelling, cracks, gouges. Be sure your coupler actuates smoothly once it's repaired. Check your wave springs to be sure there's no corrosion or cracking. And be sure that the poppet is not scored or damaged in any way.